Hello everyone, let us continue with the analysis of portal frame. This is the last problem on the portal frame. So this is the last problem on the portal frame. So this portal frame consists of two story. This is first story, this is second story, and two bays. So in the horizontal direction we call it as a bay. This is one bay, this is another bay. So in the vertical direction we call a story. The first story, second story. So this whole structure consists of totally sub four portal frames of same size. This is 6 by 3, but horizontal is 6 and vertical is 3. This is also 6 by 3, 6 by 3. So here what I will do, I will create only one portal frame of size 6 by 3 and I will replicate the same for the other. So I will show how to replicate the portal frame. So the starting point is from origin, it is 0, 0. I will create this one, origin X 3 by 6 by 3. So click on 0, the vertical is 3 and the horizontal is 6. And click on close. So this is the one portal frame of size 6 by 3. So you are seeing only this one, 6 by 3. Now I want here one frame, vertical one frame. First I will replicate the same portal frame on the right side. So see how to do that one. Select whole frame and click on translation and repeat. So on which side you are replicating? Along x-axis, it is positive x-axis, like this you are replicating. So number of step is, you have to replicate only one step. This is the first step. So what is the x distance you have to replicate? That is 6. So global direction is x, number of step is 1, and the distance is 6 meter. Click on OK. So it is replicated now. So now we are seeing two bays. Now I want one more story. This is one story with the two bays. Now select whole structure. Again select, click on translation and repeat. So now you are replicating along vertical direction, that is Y axis. Click on global direction Y. Number of step is, again it is, you are replicating only for once. So number of step is 1. The vertical distance is 3 meter. Number the distance is 3 meter. Okay. Now you are seeing two bays and two story. So if you want to view the dimension, click on dimension to the view. Okay. Now you can see that this is 3, this is 3, 6, 6, 3, 3. So to remove, again click on dimension, remove. Next is you have to assign the property. This is for columns, the moment of inertia is I. For the beam, it is moment of inertia is 3i. So click on general, define, select general, give the moment of inertia at 0.00001. Add, next for 3i, multiplied by 3, add. This one, select, use cursor to assign, assign. Or else there is another step is there to select only column. To select column, you can use the mouse and you can select like this. And next, for the next, to select some more columns, you use control button and click select. Click on this one, this one and this one. Like this also you have to, you can assign to the selected beams. Yes. Next, if you want to assign, select this beam, control, use control button and click on the lines. Like this you can select, or else some one more option is there, select beams parallel to. So So these are parallel to x-axis. These are beams parallel to y-axis. Beams parallel to x-axis. See, already got selected. Select this one. Okay, select beams parallel to x-axis. You have to assign this one. Select to assign the beams. Select yes. Close. Now the property is assigned. Next step is you have to assign the support conditions. Fixed. Support, create, fixed, add, select this one, assign, close. So the last step is you have to assign the load. The load is uniformly distributed load, that is minus 120. It is acting over whole span of the beam. So select loads and definitions, load case details, add, give the name as load case one, click on add, close. Select load case one, add, that is member load, uniform distributed load, that is minus 120. It is acting along global y-axis, these are zero, add, close. Select this one, use cursor to assign, click on this one, this beam and this beam. Now the load is assigned. So we will scale down the distributed load. So right click, labels, load value and scales. So increase this one, I will increase by some 200. Okay. Now you are able to see the load values. The load scale has been reduced. Next last step is you have to analyze the frame. Click on analysis bar print, no print, close. Next is analyze, run analysis, save. So zero error is there. Click on go to proceed mode, done. Select load case one, okay. So this is the deflection. Unclick this one. Then click on result setup, result view options, enable automatic scaling for shear and bending, apply, okay. Bending moment diagram. So click on results, view value, beam results. And similarly, let us select the shear force also and displacement also. So now you are seeing the bending moment diagram. So let us verify the results. So it is 42.42. One is a 42.35. It is 169.5 is there, 169.4, 454. This is hogging, this is sagging, this is hogging. This is 169.4 is there, 169.5. So the results are correct. Similarly, you can view the shear force diagram, the deflection, and to view the reactions. This is the reactions. So these are the values. At node 1, the horizontal reaction is 42.419. Vertical reaction is 640. At node 4, this is the fourth node. Horizontal reaction is not there, only vertical reaction, that is 1598.56 kilonewton. It at node 6, minus 42, and the vertical reaction is 640, and bending moment also you can see. So to view the reaction diagrammatically, you can click on results, view value, reactions, show lines, increase the scale, annotate, close. Now you are seeing the reactions, vertical reaction and horizontal reaction. Here the bending moment is zero. It is not carrying any bending moment. Only node 1 and node 4 are carrying the bending moment. So this completes the portal frame. So let us end the class.